Living Christ Deliverance Ministries, delivering souls, delivering nations.
31 to 33.
Kubva pandima ya 31 kusvika pandima ya 33.
First Chronicles.
Makoronike okutanga.
Chapter 12 from verse 31 to verse 33. Can you read for us from the Bible?
Makoronike okutanga chitsauko 12 ndima 31. Kuhafu yorudzi rwaManase zviuru zvine gumi nezvisere vakanga vakanyorwa mazita avo vakasvika kuzoita Dhavhidhi mambo. Kuvana vaIsaka, kuvarume vaiziva nguva zvakanaka uye kuti vaIsraeri vanofanira kuitei, vakuru vavo vaive mazana maviri, hama dzavo dzose dzairayirwa navo. Verse 33. KuvaZebhuruni avo vaigona kufamba namapoka nokugona kurongedza hondo vakabata nhumbi dzose dzokurwa nadzo vaiva nezviuru zvina zvina makumi mashanu vaigona kurwa vasine mwoyo miviri.
May God bless the reading of the word. Can you read for us from an English Bible?
Verse 31. End of the half tribe of Manasseh, 18,000 which were expressed by name to come and make David the king. And the children of Issachar, which were men that had understanding of the times to know what Israel ought to do. The heads of them were 200, and of their brethren at their commandment. Of Zebulun, such as went forth to battle expert in war, with all instruments of war, 50,000 which could keep rank, they were not of double heart.
May God bless the reading of the word. Can you go to the book of Luke again?
Ruka.
Chapter 1, verse 3.
Chitsauko 1, Dimaya 3. Nenivo dakati, danyato fea zose, kuvapa kutanga, ndikati zvakanaka kuti ndikunyorereiwo nokutevedzanisa imi Tiofiro makakumbira. Verse 3 in English. It seemed good to me also, having a perfect understanding of all things from the very first, to write unto thee in order, most excellent Theophilus.
May God again bless the reading of the word.
Mwari varopafadze kuverengwa kweshoko ravo.
May you kindly elevate your hand, right hand, and allow me to pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, I thank you, Lord, and I bless you. I raise my voice this moment in time, Father.
Yes, Lord.
Acknowledging that you are present amongst us and you are a God that has called us.
Yes, Jesus.
To be yours, O Father, from the beginning of time.
Yes, Lord.
We thank you for this moment, O Father, for we are here to receive, Father, in our spirits.
Yes, Jesus.
And also into our lives.
Yes, Lord.
Your blessing of the word. Father, may you minister to us.
Jesus.
Give us our daily bread.
Yes, Lord.
So that we may grow in understanding, O Father.
Jesus.
Of who you are and what we are.
Jesus.
In the name of Jesus Christ, Father, I pray.
Yes, Lord.
I come, O Lord Jehovah, even against every power, every entity of the spiritual dimension against the word of God.
Yes, Lord.
That might, Father, derail, disturb us from receiving what we have preserved for us today.
Jesus.
In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Father, I seek you.
Yes, Lord.
Be with us. Touch our lives. Strengthen us through your word. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, may the church of God shout a glorious amen.
Amen.
You can do better. Shout a better amen.
Amen.
Are you ready for the word of God?
Yes.
Let me see your hand if you are ready to receive something from God. Whenever we are in the house of God, I believe now our teachings, or my teachings about the importance
ndinotenda kuti dzidziso pamusoro pekukosha
of the word of God is
shoko ra Jehovah ndeyekuti
now taking root in your spirit
zvakudzika midzi mweya wako
the picture of us understanding how powerful and important
wekunzwisisa kusimba nekukosha
of the word of God is in our lives
kweshoko ra Jehovah zviri muupenyu hwedu.
The situation that we are living in this particular time.
Mamirire zvino hatiri kurarama pari panguva ino.
Demands us to be rooted in the word of God.
Anoda kuti tinge tine nheyo mushoko raJehovah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The greatest gift that God gave to mankind.
Chipo chikuru chakapiwa naJehovah kumuno.
Was the release of his word.
Kwaive kuregedzera kweshoko rake.
That became flesh.
Rakave nyama.
And dwelt amongst us.
Rikafamba pakati pedu.
The word dwelt amongst us.
Shoko rakafamba pakati pedu.
And came to a time.
Rikashika panguva.
Whereby it was crucified.
Iyo yakaroverwa.
On the cross.
Pamchinjiko.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And its main intention and agenda was to redeem us.
Ririre kuti tsikinura.
And bring us back into the presence of God.
Roti dzosa zvekare muvepo waJehovah.
Back into the reach of God.
Kudzoka panosvikirwa naJehovah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the word that we have received.
Shoko ratakagashira.
Is the one that we have to hold dear.
Dora tinofarira kubata zvine simba.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I know during this lockdown.
Dinoziva panguva yelockdown ino.
A lot of people were affected.
Roka kanganisika.
Thank God you are here.
Tinotenda Mwari uri pano.
But some of you still hold the scars.
Asiva mwenyu muchiri muchitori nemavanga.
Of what happened or what is happening?
Ezvakaitika nezviri kuitika.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are in a battlefield.
Tiri muhondo
that the enemy has put us in.
Yataiswa nemuvengi mairi.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I don't know how you perceive this.
Andisive kuti unozviona sei.
Or how you see it.
Unozviona sei.
But we are in a battlefield.
Asi tiri muhondo.
And a lot is demanded from us.
Zvizhinji zviri kudiwa kubva patiri.
We have lost a lot.
Tarasikirwa nezvizhinji.
And a lot has been done to us.
Zvizhinji zvaitwa kwatiri.
Some of us cannot see the scars and the wounds.
Vamwe vedu hationi mavanga nemaronda.
Of what have been inflicted upon us.
Ezvaitwa patiri.
But in due course you are going to see them.
Asi panguva ichakwana muchazviona.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The church of God is under attack.
Kereke yaJehovah iri pakurwiswa.
The devil is out there to erase everything called a gathering of saints.
Wakaipa ari kunze uku ari kuda kutsima chese chinonzi ungano yevanotenda.
And now as he is scattering people.
Zvino achidzinga vanhu seizvi.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
What you have inside you.
Chaunacho mauri.
Is what will maintain you and preserve you.
Ndoji chakuchengetedza.
What you received.
Chawaka gashira
is going to strengthen you.
Chichakusimbisa.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But now as we have gathered like this today.
Zvino taungana seizvi nhasi.
Our spiritual banks. Our
banga.
Spiritual banks.
Banga redu remweya.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Some of us are now going to the level of empty.
Vamwe vedu takuenda kuchiyero chekugumisira.
You no longer have anything that you can draw from within you that can strengthen you.
Hausisina chimwe chinhu chaunogona kubudisa mauri chingakusimbisa.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And what the enemy is doing is making sure that you suffer at every corner of your life, at every avenue of your life.
Ndichekuona kuti washushikana kwese kune kubata muupenyu wako.
You are not allowed to go and worship God.
Hausikutendera kunonamata.
Freely as you had, we had gone used to.
Wakasununguka sekujairira kwatanga taita.
At the same time you are not allowed to go and work.
Sekare hausikutendera kunoshanda.
Hallelujah. For your family as you are used to.
Sikushandira mhuri sezvo wajaira.
And now life is very difficult.
Zvino upenyu hwaoma.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And you have to hide and run away from a disease that is declared incurable.
Hallelujah. Amen.
And all these things are happening around you. And you are used to get into the house of God, and when you see sister Ninge or see brother somebody, your spirit is lifted up and you are not allowed to gather. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You are used to get on a Sunday service and you get revived when you get somebody who preaches the word to you. And now that opportunity has been denied of you. You are now unable to have those privileges. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And now where you stand is a difficult place. You are in a difficult place. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And as the devil is watching, he's expecting to see you break down. Because he knows you cannot preach to yourself. Hallelujah. Some of us cannot teach themselves. The Bible says David encouraged himself in the Lord. But a few of us are not like David, who is able to encourage himself in the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because life is hard. We have been thrown into the fire. We are in the fiery furnace. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And it is in such instances and such times that you don't need any other word but a word that is going to remove you from the fiery furnace
and
change your perspective of everything so that you understand what you are supposed to do. Am I talking to somebody here? Shout amen, somebody.
Amen.
Shout amen, somebody.
Amen.
We read here from the book of Chronicles. I love this chapter so much because it speaks of the types of men that David, that came to David while he was in the wilderness at Ziklag. Remember, David had already run away from Saul. And Saul had sent troops to go and look for him. Hallelujah. And he was running in the wilderness.
Why tiza ari murenje?
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And when Saul dies,
pakafa Sauro,
or when Saul is killed,
Sauro aurayiwa,
the Bible says the Israelites,
Bible wrote my Israel,
then decided to enthrone David as their king.
Akasarudza kugadza Davida samambo.
And David is in the wilderness.
Davida ari kurenje.
And him being in the wilderness,
ari kurenje kudaro.
The Bible says God built an army for him.
Bible wrote mwari wakaumba hondo yake.
There were men that came to him in the wilderness.
Kune varume vakauya kwaari ari murenje.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, I understand so much when
Tino,
I
see
what David was going through.
Zvakasangana naDavida.
God had put him, God had ordained him, God had anointed him.
Wakanga amuzodza, amugadza.
But he was not at the place where he was supposed to be. Hallelujah. And now any king, if he is to remain or to be, or if anyone is to remain in power, he has to have a strong army that backs him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And now God saw it that since Saul now had departed, he had to raise an army for David. And amongst the people that he sent to him, hallelujah, were the 30 mighty men. There is a whole chapter written about these men who did great exploits of war. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And yet so many different people who came to him.
And
from verse 31 to verse
33,
we come across another group of people that came to him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And now this group of people that came were also the sons of Issachar. And also the sons of Zebulun. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And these two people, two groups of people, were different. Firstly, the sons of Issachar, we are told that they were men who understood the seasons or the times. They had an understanding of time. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
As I was thinking deep to try and understand what is the writer saying when he's saying they had the understanding of times, I came to realize that these men, the sons of
Issachar,
started the patterns of how things happen. They had an understanding that things happen at a certain pattern. They knew how things happened. And they knew that each action bore a certain consequence. And they knew that this time interpreted that we are supposed to do this and also do that. They knew the seasons. And they knew what was supposed to be done in those particular seasons. Am I talking to somebody here?
Amen.
Are you hearing me, church?
Amen.
Are you hearing me, church?
Yes.
They knew. They had knowledge. God given knowledge. To know what is supposed to be done. To know what is supposed to be done. And in this case, the Bible says, they knew what Israel was supposed to do. Going to verse 33, you hear of this group again. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Those of Zebulun. The Bible here tells us that they had a skill, they knew how to fight a warfare. They were skilled. Hallelujah.
Amen.
In terms of warfare. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm fasting. Hey, I'm on the fast.
Jesus.
Thank you so much. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
They knew exactly how.
Why is Siva?
They knew how to apply strategies of war and tactics of warfare.
Zira ze ondo.
And they were also part of the group or part of the people that came to David at the wilderness.
Zekarira ive bokare vanhu rakauya kukuna Davida pam ari murenje.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And now, why did I choose these two groups particularly?
Say in the Saruza, Mapoka Mavira, Zaganyanya.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
There are so many, as you go down, you find so many.
Why Shinji? Uchivere ngochitzika unoana wa Shinji.
As the Spirit of God was teaching me, he told me that we have to understand that we are in a season where David was. As David was anointed to be the king of Israel. Hallelujah. He had to have a backing of an army that knew what was coming or what was supposed to be done. Hallelujah.
Amen.
For him to remain in place or to remain in power. Firstly, he needed God. But he also needed people around him. Hallelujah. He needed men who knew how to fight a warfare. Hallelujah.
Amen.
One thing that I've realized that the church has lacked. Number one is the tactic of fighting a warfare. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The combination between the sons of Issachar and the sons of Zebulun was that one group. The sons of Issachar knew what was supposed to be done. And the other group knew how to fight a warfare. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
In life, or as a body of Christ, or as a child of God, you have to have this understanding that as we are in a battlefield of such magnitude, we have to have around us, or have a spirit of understanding, the times, number one. And number two, what is supposed to be done at that particular time. And also know how to conduct our warfare. The church of God is bleeding right now. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Why? Because we don't have the knowledge.
How
do you confront a situation like the one we are going through? How do you remain standing? How do you fight? How do you win a battle of such a magnitude? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Though David was prophetic,
though
David had a priestly anointing,
though
David had a kingly anointing, he had a triune anointing flowing in his life, but he still needed men. Hallelujah. Who could fight the battle on the ground? He needed men who knew what to do around him. By talking to somebody here. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And because of this weakness, the enemy has risen against us. So many people don't know what they are supposed to do now. Child of God, what do you do in such a situation? What is it that you are supposed to do now? What time are we in now? What name have you given to the season that you are in now? And what are you doing about the season, and what, how are you fighting in that season? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
There is confusion in the world right now. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And now people,
Zinovan,
you know, the Spirit of God opened my eyes and I saw painful things. I saw children of God. People that were once spiritual. People who loved God. Confused. Not knowing what to do now. And as all this is happening, do you know that there is another side? There are other people who are now celebrating. There are some people who are celebrating right now in this particular time. They are seeing themselves going strides from one level to another level. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I was driving to town. And I was coming As I was coming, I saw
Ndikaona
a group of people who were worshiping in the wilderness. You know them.
Vazhinji vanga vachinamata vari musango.
Their numbers are growing.
Vari kuwanda.
They don't have a lockdown.
Havana lockdown.
They are not on lockdown.
Havasi pa lockdown.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And numbers are what? And some of our members are even going there.
Vamwe vedu vakutoenda ikoko.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I'm asking myself,
what's
going through the mind of an LCDM daughter, LCDM son, going to a shrine,
and yet there is
such information that has been disposed to this person. So much armament that has been released, so much anointing that has been released, and what's really going on? What's happening? And the Spirit of God said to me, you know what? You have to know that it is one thing to disseminate information or disseminate anointing, and it is another thing to receive the anointing and apply it. Hallelujah. You can be immersed in the anointing and yet so weak and even die in that anointing. Because you don't understand and also know what has been given to you. You don't know what you are supposed to do. You don't. You are unable to interpret the season that you are in. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
David needed such people around him. Why? Because it is imperative to have people who are sensitive of what is supposed to be done. As the Spirit of God was teaching me, he said, David did not need to speak twice for anything to happen. Why? Because there were a people amongst him who understood or knew what was supposed to be done, and they had the inspiration of the Spirit of God aligned with the word given to David. And anytime you speak, they will rise. Whenever you speak, they will hear twice. As you read the Bible going forward, you hear of David speaking of three men. They were at the back front and he said, speaking just out of nowhere, just speaking. And he says,
I thirst for water.
He's speaking, just speaking literally. And the men take it as a command. They face the enemy, three of them. They penetrate through the enemy wall. They go to the well and they take the water. They come with the water to David. Hallelujah. And when David saw the men coming to him, he says, who am I to drink this water? With what you have done, sacrificing your life, I did not command you. But as he spoke from nowhere, they took it as a command. They were that sensitive. Because they were at war. There is nothing so dangerous than to have people who are insensitive while you are in a battlefield. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I know this firsthand because I was a soldier.
You know,
I know that if you have people who are not sensitive enough, who are not vigilant enough, who cannot understand and interpret the situations, they can cost you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Am I speaking to somebody here? Look at your neighbor and say, ask your neighbor, how vigilant are you? How sensitive are you? Do you know what time are we in? Hallelujah. Do you know what is supposed to be done? And what are you doing right now? Because what you are doing right now can either lengthen the season.
Zvinogona kuwedzera kureba kwemwaka.
It can either take us out of the season very fast.
Kana kukuburitsa mwaka nekuchimbika.
Or it can make our situation worse.
Kana kukuwedzera. Amire zvino.
Am I talking to somebody here?
Ndinotaura nemunhu here.
As long as we have got a people.
Tine vanhu.
Who do not know
vasingazive
what they are supposed to do or where they are or what time they are in.
Nenguva yavari mairi.
We are in trouble.
Tiri padambudziko.
Am I talking to somebody here? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.